A very good afternoon to everyone. As our esteemed guest lecture speaker today, given in a detailed view about the role of forensic odontology in forensic science, I would like to present about an upcoming useful tool, that is pertinence of 3D printing in forensic odontology. A review. Here's my content. Forensic dentistry is a significant part of forensic science, and it has been an integral part of criminal investigation. 3D printing is a procedure that is used to generate a 3D model by using a digital data, and it represents any evidence without any bias with minimal degradation, hence it reduces subjective errors. It uses successive layering of material to build up an object in three dimensions, and thereby it is also known as additive manufacturing. Date back to 1984, Charles Hull, an American engineer who developed the world's first working printer, and he defined it as a system for generating three-dimensional object by creating a cross-sectional pattern of the object to be formed. In 1986, he developed a commercially available printer machine that named as stereolithography apparatus. Basic 3D printing protocol, how does it work? First step is imaging using CBCT, CT, MRI. We saved it as a DICOM file format, converted to STL and CAD software, creating virtual prototype model, and choose an appropriate 3D printing technique. And printing is done layer by layer to achieve final structure. Post-production refining that include cleaning, finishing, polishing, and sterilization. So this whole process can be divided into three parts: image acquisition, image post-processing, and 3D printing. In image acquisition, CT images are most commonly used because of their wide spectrum of applications, ease of image post-processing, high contrast, signal-to-noise ratio, spatial resolution. It enhances structure differentiation and minimizes partial volume effects. And the most important is image section should be reconstructed with isotropic voxels of 1.25 mm or less, because thicker section can compromise the model accuracy. Conversion of, this is the diagrammatic representation of conversion of CT scan data to three-dimensional model. In image post-processing, first step is accurate tissue segmentation of desired tissue. Software generate a printable 3D STL model and convert of these 3D surfaces to STL triangular facets. And CAD/CAM software is most commonly used for 3D manipulation. After all these adjustments, data transfer to 3D printers. All the 3D printers use data encoded in the STL file to deposit and then fuse successive 3D layers of materials. Here are some 3D models which are fabricated using their digital information. Techniques. There are various techniques used in 3D printing. Some of them are fused deposition modeling, material using polylactic acid, direct light processing, material using photopolymer resin, stereolithography, selective laser sintering, and many more. So we can use different techniques using different materials according to the requirement. Applications of 3D printing in forensic odontology are, first is bite mark analysis. So bite mark analysis is a dynamic process which includes number of factors. First, forensic dentist must identify and verify the bite marks, then position of jaws, teeth, number of teeth present, size and shape of the teeth. Traditionally, stone pour technique was used to record bite marks where pressure can distort the teeth mark. But in 3D printing, digital scanners eliminate this external pressure distortion. And it is also very useful in cases where taking an impression can be difficult, like in genital organs, breast and buttock regions. In keloscopy, 3D printing is also very useful in keloscopy as taking impression with stone pour technique cannot be reliable, and also accuracy can be compromised due to shrinkage. So 3D printing eliminates this distortion. Like in rugoscopy also, digital scanners used to take photographs of 3D models. Facial reconstruction can play an important role in identification of unknown individual from their skeletal remains by using tissue markers and a material such as clay. In dental age estimation, 3D models of mandible can be used for the estimation of age estimation using the gonial angles. In sex determination, measurements of intercanine distance, intermolar distance, the overjet, overbite, tooth size, and arch length can be measured using 3D models. In bone pattern injuries, pattern of fracture may provide information about cause of fracture, which can be very useful in criminal investigation, and it also very useful in ballistic injuries, where it can used in identification and reconstruction of weapons used, and it can also trace the path of a bullet. Here are some cases where 3D printing has been used and played a very important role to solve the cases. In 2013, Japanese police used printed skull model to solve a 6-year-old girl with the help of forensic expert. In 2015, England police also used the 3D scanning models. In 2016, skeletal remains were found in Ohio, USA, and they produced 3D models of these remains and used in the identification process of an individual. In India, Johnson et al. In 2019 conducting an experimental study using an innovative digital approach of forensic tooth reconstruction using three-dimensional printed tooth retrieved from intra-alveolar morphology of empty dental sockets. Advantages are, it gave higher level of interaction and allows for the visual representation of evidence. It is non-invasive, non-contact technique, maintain the integrity of the original materials. It is time feasible, objects can be scaled down and scaled up, and range of materials, colors, texture and flexibility can be used according to the requirements, and we can reevaluate printed samples even after many years. Disadvantages are, it is cost effective and one should have a very good expertise in 3D printings. It could be health hazardous and it cannot be used to print 3D models of a tooth where socket wall is fractured. So I conclude by saying this, 3D printed models of bone and teeth can be useful to forensic odontologists in both analysis and as an exhibit in evidence, which can provide the clarity of communication in the courtroom. These are my references. Thank you.